Step aside for Earthquake Magoon, busted out all over like June. I stand on the corner in Ole Miss and Ornery, making the fair sex swoon. My secret desire is to tangle with Daisy May.
You just better catch yourself somebody else. with the detestable but ever available Joan.
Matt?
That's pretty good for the average man. But tell me, Sam, since I was prepared to extend myself financially, what has you in a $2 wedding?
My $2 wedding? My boy, it is spectacular. First, I strips to the waist and wrestles the four biggest guests, male or female. Morning, ladies.
Morning, Mary and Sam.
Go on, my good man.
Next, I tells four off-color jokes guaranteed to embarrass man or beast. Then as the applause dies down, I dances and jigs with a pig, ties my arms and legs to four infuriated mules, and as they run off in all directions trying to tell me apart, I recites five of the more dynamic speeches of Alf Landon, backwards.
Sounds all right for the lower classes, but the lady I has in mind is entitled to something a little more hoi polloi. Morning, ladies. My Daisy May, you is looking especial pretty today.
Thank you, Mr. McGoon.
And just what does a rat varmint like you want with information about a $2 wedding?
Well, it could be I'm fixing to get married since I just returned home with my newly acquired title, namely, World's Dirtiest Wrestler. That being so well, he'll naturally I aims to wed me a certain dog patch gal.
You crazy or something?
You know a man can't claim a gal down here, unless she catches him herself on Sadie Hawkins' day.
If you want the answers, I suggest you perambulates over to the fogbound meeting that's about to be held at Compone Square.
Compone Square?
You mean that's going to be a compone meeting?
By direct request of my good friend, the Senator Jackass Fogbound.
This will be serious.
But we only have compone meetings, so events of national importance.
Or a hideous change in the dog patch way of life.
Oh, there's gonna be a hideous change, all right. Come on, Sam, tell me about your $4 wedding.
Well, I don't crave your business, but I can't discriminate. First, I clip your toenails, gives you a quick shave and a sponge bath if you needs it. Frankly, I'd say you needs it. Next, I make a shocking proposal to the bride's mother.
Over and flick that fly off of my nose.
Nah.
Why not?
I ain't in a fly flicking mood. If I was in a fly flicking mood, I'd flick the fly off of my own nose.
Oh.
Sounds like something's bothering you.
Bitch, I know Sadie Hawkins Day coming up.
Abner, you figuring on letting Daisy May catch her this year?
Don't think so. It ain't worth the price.
What price?
Giving up your druthers.
Which druthers?
All of them. While you druther go hunting, she druther stay home. You druther do this, she druther do that. I tells you, the day you kiss your bride hello, you kiss your druthers goodbye.
I didn't know your druthers was that important to you.
Important? If I had my druthers, I'd rather have my druthers than anything else I know. While you draw the hustle, accumulate muscle, I'd rather watch daisies grow. I sit there for hours, developing my powers, of figuring how flowers gets tall. If I had my druthers, I'd rather have my druthers than anything else I know. Than anything else I know. Choose from all the others, I'd rather be like I am. This thing called employment detracts from my enjoyment and tightens my diaphragm. While I'm doing nary a thing that's necessary, I'm happy as a cherry stone clam. If I had my druthers to choose from all the others, I'd rather be like I am, yes ma'am. I'd rather be like I am.
Abner, if you could be anyone in the whole world, who would you druther be?
Me.
Just you?
Just me.
What's so special about just being you?
Nothing so special. It's just so handy. That's all.
The meeting.
Ain't going to no meeting.
Thought I might walk along with you to the meeting.
But I'd rather stay here.
Thought we might do some talking about some things that might need some talking about.
Well, maybe we ought to do some talking.
Ain't going to no meeting, Daisy. You run along.
But Abner, Sadie Hawkins Day is next Friday. And if we's ever gonna do some talking about some things.
Abner's got a girlfriend.
Ain't going to no meeting, Daisy.
But Abner.
I ain't a going. I have spoken.
All right. I'll just tell Mammy you ain't a coming to the cone pone meeting.
Cone pone meeting?
Of course.
You didn't say it was a corn pone meeting.
You didn't let me.
To hear that, fellas, a corn pone meeting. Must be a national emergency. We better get down there quick. This might call for some brains or something. Daisy, fetch me my worms.
Wishes that we were friends. I turn
this here upstanding community of dog patch, I'm an honor being with the dog meat, declares open this solemn jubilation tea cornpone meeting.
Cornpone meeting?
Pa, who's jubilation tea cornpone?
Hey, shut up.
This meeting was requested by our esteemed senator, the Honorable Jack S. Trogbaum.
Come here, Scarlet. Scarlet, honey, it's high time you knew this town was founded by that beloved man, a setting up there on that horse, Jubilation T. Cornpone. The greatest fighting general, the military strategist the Confederacy ever knew.
Was he brave?
Brave? Why, J.T. Cornpone didn't know the meaning of the word fear. Terror, yes, but fear, never. And all over the countryside, there's monuments commemorating the names of his famous battles.
The jazz?
Cornpone's disaster. Cornpone's misjudgment. Cornpone's catastrophe. And Cornpone's humiliation.
When he fought the Yankees at Annihilation Museum, who was there so in the charge that took us into the rear home? The crops and the bus, not the eat.
Why, it was Jubilation Cornpone.
Oh, September Cornpone.
Jubilation Cornpone.
The pants blown off his seat.
Hooray!
When it seemed like our brave boys might keep on fighting for months,
you tell!
Who took pity on them and capitulated at once?
Why, it was Jubilation Cornpone.
Unshaped and shorn.
Jubilation Cornpone, he made the country race.
in the sunshine of your warm greeting forever.
Bask on your own time, Fogbone.
Yeah, get to the point.
Well, I bet you all been wondering what I've been doing down in Washington these last 18 years.
We didn't care just so long as you was there and we was here.
What? Senator, tell them what you've done for us down in Washington.
Well, I done got the United States Senate to pass the Jack S. Fogbound bill. Obscure, unknown, poverty-stricken dog patch is gonna become world famous.
And just what for is we gonna be famous for? What for?
You is gonna save the lifeblood of a vigorous and thriving American industry. That's what for.
Well, which industry is that, Senator?
My boy, a glorious industry dedicated solely to the stimulation and relaxation so necessary for the American businessman. An industry known as Las Vegas.
Las Vegas?
Ain't that where they do all that gambling?
Yes, sir, Mammy Yoakum. And right there's their trouble. You see, in a desert nearby, the government's attesting certain nuclear weapons of war.
Hey, Tom Bob!
That's right, and the atomic dust from them bombs is a-coming down and a-floating in them Las Vegas swimming pools and on them beautiful green felt crap-shooting tables.
No!
I tell you, the dice is a-turning so black, hiding them spots, you can't hardly tell if you got snake eyes or boxcars.
No!
I tell you, that green felt's a-turning so brown, you can't tell if your money's playing the field or come in the hard way.
No!
And the colors is going on them slot machines. If you wins a jackpot, you don't dare touch your money, cause it might be radioactive. Oh!
I just hate the way you've done that.
But does you think your government is gonna stand by and let a tragedy like this happen to an American industry to whom so many have given so much for so little?
No,
my good friends. And that is why the Jack S. Fogbound Committee has been chosen.
To find a new place to test them bombs!
That's right. Some place we can blow off the face of this earth. Some place that ain't never gonna be missed. In fact, the most unnecessary place in the whole USA. And I now has the honor and privilege of announcing to you that after a four-year governmental survey of all the no-account, unnecessary places in the whole country, you has been selected as the most unnecessary of all. Now, you all's got to be moved out of here by the United States government. And here is the fine government scientist who is going to supervise your evacuation. Citizens, meet Dr. Rasmussen T. Pinsdale.
Friends, we intend to move you from dog patch to a necessary place in our society. The evacuation will start immediately. Thank you and good luck.
Now, my beloved constituents, as I bid you farewell, I beg of you, don't let me down. Your government is spending $1 million on one bomb to blow your homes off the face of this earth. So show your appreciation.
Don't let me take the ram off the moon.
Thank you. please, and listen close. I wants to add to this glorified occasion by making a history-creating romantic announcement. I hereby claims as my bride in marriage none other than the ever-popular Miss Daisy May.
How dare you ever get him a phone?
Why, bust his head wide open, I will.
Wait a minute. I does the head busting for this family. Lagoon, you crazy. You know you can't claim the gal down here unless she catches you on Sadie Hawkins Day.
You just heard the man. He's dropping the bomb on Wednesday. Sadie Hawkins Day ain't till Friday. So there can't be no more Sadie Hawkins Day.
No more Sadie Hawkins Day! What are we gonna do?
Mad dog meat, I object.
Overruled. Now, since there ain't gonna be no more Sadie Hawkins Day, we automatically goes back to the code of the hill.
Whereby if a male desires marriage with a female of the opposite sex, he can claim his beloved if and he gets approval of her next of kin. Right, Mayor Dog Meat?
Right.
Therefore, I claims in marriage the aforementioned ever-popular Daisy May.
Well, now, is there any other place? He's gonna have
Wait.
To.
I also claims the ever popular lady in question.
You does what?
I claims Daisy May.
For the purpose of marriage?
Well, whatever he's claiming her for, I's claiming her for.
Well, we have two claimers. The choice is gonna have to be decided by Daisy May's next of kin.
Been decided.
Huh?
She's already been promised to me by my good friend, Daisy's closest relative, the ever sensible Romeo Scrag.
Scrag?
Romeo Scrag!
He's a no good varmint. Object!
Objects too!
Hesha, I'm not as objective for this family.
Why, I'm just as objectionable as you.
Yes, both objectionable. Daisy, is Romeo Scrag your kinfolk or ain't he?
Well. Yes, but it's a side of the family that...
Oh, one's a scrag, always a scrag.
Romeo, is it true? Did you give Daisy May to Earthquake Lagoon?
Correct.
How could you make such a miserable decision?
Cause Earthquake's a good man, a fine man, a man who puts love in his heart, puts faith in his country. You just put $4 in my pocket. Bless you, my children.
Nuptials will be announced later. Now, let's get on with our plans for the evacuation of Dog Patch.
Mammy, do something!
Just a minute. I got something to say. Is there a scientist man around here?
Yes, yes. What is it?
You go place because you couldn't find anything necessary about it, right?
Correct, madam.
Well, suppose we did find something necessary. What then?
Well, we certainly would not bomb any community who made a necessary contribution to our society.
Okay, then let's go spread out and find something necessary.
Yeah, we've got to save old Sadie Hawkins Day.
We got to protect the rights of womanhood.
You just heard your fellow citizens. They want us to get up and get out of here.
Yeah, we all want to get out.
These fine young maidens have a right to get out of this miserable pest hole and see the outside world.
That's right, Manny. We want to just spread out. We want to get citified,
culturized,
modernized. We want to broaden our horizons.
Oh, you want to broaden your horizon, does you? Well, let me tell you something. Your horizons are broad enough already, particularly yours. You got any idea what they got waiting out there for you? The horrible, miserable customs?
Like what?
Like a before-marriage custom called an engagement.
Engagement? What's that?
That's the time that elapses between when a gal says, she'll do, and the preacher says, go to.
How long does an engagement thing last?
Sometimes a whole month.
Whole month? That's unhealthy. Could ruin your skin.
Yes, my good friends. You're gonna have to do all kinds of wonderful things out there. You're gonna have to take baths.
No!
Comb your hair.
No!
Clean your nails.
necessary.
Well, Abner, don't you realize what you just done? You finally asked me to marry you.
Yeah, I know.
Abner, why'd you do it?
Well, I don't know. I just ups and done it, that's all.
But why?
Well, there you were, your sweet usual self. And there was old Earthquake looking at you like a hound dog on the first day of hunting season. And I ain't gonna let nobody look at you like a hound dog, especially a hound dog like Magoo. So I ups and done it, that's all.
Oh, Adam, does this mean you ain't slipping me ketchup if we have Sadie Hawkins died?
Reckon so.
Oh, Adam, what took you so long?
Well, I don't know. Some years I was wanting to all bad, but I couldn't. Don't know why I couldn't, but I couldn't.
Well, that's all behind us now. And life's gonna be full of so many wonderful things. Things you've been deserved for such a long, long time.
Well, namely, what?
Move along now. Next.
Hi, Adam. So
to this, Sam.
But there's no printing in it. The pages are all blank.
Well, we didn't have any money that year, so they just sent it out as a goodwill gesture.
Interesting, my good man, but hardly a necessity.
Well, might be if you live in Dogpat.
Pack your things. The trucks will be leaving immediately.
Wait a minute. Here comes a barrel with Jones. He'll have something if anyone will.
I got it. I got it. The most necessary innovation in modern times.
Quickly, quickly now. What is it?
Here, put these on. Stupefying Jones.
What does it do?
A deadly weapon guaranteed to stupefy any human male dead in his tracks. I'll demonstrate. Hey, those are ball cannons. Come over here. Stupefy. Unstupefy.
What do you want?
Oh, nothing. Well?
Fascinating, but of what utility?
Why, she'd be invaluable to college football. Why, she could stop Columbia at the one-yard line.
Who could? Next.
Wait a minute. I got it. I really got it.
It's Mammy. Oh, last hope.
If you's looking for something necessary to the whole country, look no more. Because I has it right here in this little jug. Our own special yokumberry tonic.
Yokumberry tonic?
I plucked it up out of the berries of our yokumberry tree.
Madam, I never heard of a yokumberry tree.
You wouldn't. There's only one in the whole world.
That's right, and it grows right in their front yard.
Man ain't interested in your phony old yokumberry tonic.
Phony? My boy Abner takes it, and just look at his muscles.
Sir, look at his muscles.
Madam, I'm sorry, but we already have more tonic and bodybuilders than we can use.
Appears to me like your body could still do with a little building.
That's enough. The evacuation will proceed immediately.
Does this mean there's just nothing about us that's necessary?
I'm afraid not. And besides, I should think you would be delighted at a chance to get out of a place like this.
You don't rightly understand, mister. It may not look like much to you, but this here is our land, our soil. Why, this is where we was raised.
It's where our kinfolk was born and home.
Where our ancestors took their bare hands and made all of this out of the wilderness. Our beautiful skunk works.
The West Polk Chop Railroad.
The beautiful intersection of Hog Fat Boulevard and Sheep Dip Drive.
Where we was planning to erect our new hotel, the Dog Patch Hill.
Not to mention Corn Pone Square.
Repulsive Rock.
Goose Grease Gulch.
And they call us unnecessary.
They just don't understand, Mammy.
God, ain't fit for human consumption.
Can it be produced inexpensively?
If you pay more than a nickel a quart, you're violating the fair trade laws.
An alcoholic beverage that could be sold to the American public for 5 cents a quart. Perhaps I'd better taste it.
There's no need to, Doctor. I'll be glad to try a little for you.
Oh, very well, if you must.
Water!
Ha! I told you!
Water, please!
Why bother with plain water? Why not try something guaranteed to build you up?
Like some yolk and berry tonic.
Has anyone ever had this before?
No one in the whole world except my boy Abner.
And it can be produced from a tree that grows only in your front yard?
That's right, it belongs to my boy Abner Yoakum.
Doctor, this is a matter of top echelon security.
Right. Yoakum, you'll have to come to Washington immediately.
Yes, sir, Your Honor.
Now attention, everyone. This yolk of berry tonic seems to have miracle-like properties that could well alter our plan for the evacuation of Dogpatch. This drug will need exhaustive testing on human guinea pigs. And since you will be the ones most affected by this, I'm asking our...
You got yourself one guinea pig right there.
Take mine, too. I'd be satisfied. Mine had a pair of shoulders.
I'd be glad if I had one shoulder like that.
Gentlemen, there's a truck waiting for you down the road.
Mr. Scientist Man, does this mean it's going to be necessary after all?
My dear young lady, if these tests fulfill their promise, not only will Dogpatch become necessary, it will become absolutely indispensable.
Yeah!
I'm Mark Simonson with a look at news on WKXE, and the world was shaken to its roots today by a White House announcement that a dog patch lad named Abner Yoakum has discovered a miracle drug which may revolutionize mankind. The government has claimed top secrecy on extensive medical tests of the Abner Yoakum drug. To establish its effectiveness, 5 patriotic citizens from dog patch have volunteered as human guinea pigs. Comprehensive tests on these 5 men started today, but the results will not be known for some time. The President of the United States has summoned Abner Yoakum to the White House for a statement of Yoakum's intentions regarding his disposition of the drug.
The ownership of the tree and the enhanced drug is completely and solely yours.
Yes, sir, Mr. President. Your Majesty.
Well, what do you intend doing with the drug?
Well, sir, as a 100% red-blooded American, I intend to do whatever is for the good of the United States, which I love and respect.
Aggies, man. That's very commendable. But, Will, you haven't answered my question. Do you intend to sell the drug?
Well, sir, since it come up out of the ground, it don't rightly belong to anyone special. So, as a 100% red-blooded American, I guess I'll just donate it free to the United States government, which I love and respect.
Well, Mr. Yoakum, you make me proud of my country.
Well, sir, that makes two of us.
Make it three!
Didn't you tell Yoakum of my offer of $1 million for the rights to manufacture that drug?
I did, General, but it won't do any good. He's only interested in what's good for the USA.
What's good for General Boo-Boo's is what's good for the USA, right?
Right. Three rolling rolls, a few huzzas, and a hip 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 hooray. What's good for General Boo-Boo's is good for the USA.
I want the manufacturing rights to that drug, and I don't care how I get them! Is Yoakum coming here?
Well, yes, but I don't think it'll do any good. He wants to give it to the government.
Didn't you tell him I could make him a better deal than the government? I have more money!
But my dear General Bullmoose,
you bumbling, incompetent, hillbilly cretin! If I owned that tonic, I could make all the money in the world! And I need it! Why, ever since I was a little child, I had a dream. A simple child's dream. And all that little child wanted was to get his hands on all the money in the world. And you, you imbecile, you shattered a little child's dream!
Woozy, sweet! Lower your voice. Relax. Mr. Yoakum is here.
Passionata, stay. I may need you. My boy, my dear boy, I'm General Bullmoose, son.
Howdy, General.
You know the senator. And this is Miss Appassionata von Climax, my, my confidential secretary.
Confidential secretary?
Yeah, you can read all about me in confidential.
Howdy, ma'am.
How do you do, Mr. Yoakum?
That's a mighty pretty fur, ma'am. Did you shoot it?
No, I kinda trapped it.
Sure is pretty. When's the season open on that stuff?
It never closes.
Yoakum, I'm offering you $1 million in cash for the rights to your drug.
But I already told the president.
President? What president?
President of the United States, which I love and respect.
Oh, that president. Forget that. I don't think you comprehend what this elixir of yours can do. Why, it'll give every male a perfect physique. It makes fat men thin, thin men fat. Builds up your corpuscles, lowers your blood pressure, softens your beard, toughens your skin, and what's more, it'll clean your teeth and leave your breath alone.
Joe got good manners, don't it?
We'll bottle it. We'll name it after you. We'll call it Yoka-Cola.
Yoka-Cola.
Son, we'll make billions. And for starters, Here's my check for $1 million.
Thanks, General. But if you don't mind, as a 100% red-blooded American, I'd rather give it to the government. Now, if you'll excuse me, they's running Sadie Hawkins Day tomorrow, and I don't want to miss it. Bye, General. Bye, Miss Confidential.
You can't give up $1 million. Believe me, my boy, it just isn't thrifty.
Oh, I know, General. But I've always been kind of sporty with money. Bye, y'all.
Well, how do you like that? Well, I'm not through. Not yet. $5? What's this Sadie Hawkins Day?
A monstrous dog patch custom where the girls chase the man and marry whomsoever they catches.
Can an outsider enter?
Sure can.
Aha. Then we'll go to dog patch. We'll enter Miss Appassionata in the race. She runs the race. She catches Abner Yoakum. She marries Abner Yoakum. And by community property, she owns half of everything he owns, especially Yoakum Barrettani. Then, if some unfortunate accident happens to befall the poor fool, you, his young widow, will be the sole possessor of the entire drug.
But Boothie! Supposing I don't catch him, I never run anymore.
You'll run this time or you'll be back at Howard Johnson's. Lockout! Can you make sure she catches him on Sadie Hawkins Day?
General, I knows the man for the job.
Passionata, pack your things. We're heading for the hills. We'll show those hillbillies what's what. Right?
Right. He makes the rules and he intends to keep them that away. What's good for General Bulbous is good for USA.
Spit without you hitting a national shrine, right, Sam?
That's right, and I ought to know, because I let a chaw tobacco go in the strong wind, it ricocheted around the Washington Monument, flew past old Lady Lincoln, and came to rest on Joppa Jefferson's dome.
Thank God it didn't hit none of the Confederacy.
Thank God!
Sam here got a $5 fine. They got a law up there saying you can't deface a national shrine.
But now, never mind about these national shrines. Tell us about all them crooks.
Weren't no crooks, Pappy. As far as I can tell, there was a right nice mess of people. And I can tell you right now that the country's doing just fine. Right, Sam?
You is so right, boy.
Them city folks and weans.
are pretty much alike,
though they used to live in the sticks.
We don't like stone or cement,
but we is in agreement
when we get down to talking politics. The country's in the very best of hands. The best of hands. The best of hands.
The country says the national debt is climbing to the sky.
And government expenditures have never been so high. It makes a fella get a leave of pride with it inside to see how our economy expands. The country's in the very best of hands.
Starts sliding in those goose feathers. Starts gaining.
I'll stop you.
He's only a couple feet behind you.
A couple feet.
please.
You reach us out your hand.
both here, crazed bachelors? When I fire us off this gun, you will disperse, backslide over tea kettle in all directions. When I fire us off this gun again, this bevy of love star and Valentine, believe me, will set off after you. There is no rules. Everything goes. Sadie Hawkins Day is officially...
Wait a minute, get back in line.
Sadie Hawkins Day is officially begun.
Thank you.
morning to you. I'm Mark Simonson with a look at news on WKXC. In our nation's capital, the secret government tests on the Abner and Yoakum miracle drug continued behind the cloak of top echelon security. While little is known of the progress of the five guinea pig volunteers from Dogpatch, rumor has it that their reactions have exceeded fondest hopes of the jubilant government scientists working in the super secret laboratory.
Nobody did, nobody did, everybody stacked.
the approach of a creditor, or I'm putting the wrong button on the drawers.
I'm so miserable, Simon.
If you feel little Abner's really in mortal trouble, why don't you go see Mammy and have her conjure up one of her visions to see if he's all right?
I did, and she's inside plenty of a vision right now. But I don't know if she can conjure all the way to Washington.
Oh, don't you worry about Mammy. She can conjure.
Well, I sure wish she'd hurry.
I can't wait till we get there. I can't wait to see what they look like.
Hi, Daisy.
Leaving for Washington to pick up our newly beautified husband. The government saved for us.
Say, what you got there?
We bought these from Available Jones.
It's a special happiness guaranteed on your second honeymoon. Do it yourself, kid.
Woo! Let's see what you got in there.
Got ourselves a black lace nightie, some sweet smelling perfume, and some background music from Ramah of the Jungle.
Evie, do you see the light? Up there?
We'll look them up.
Be sure to tell him. I hope he'll be happy.
Sure, Daisy. We'll tell him.
Come on! We gotta get to the station!
Bye, Sam!
Bye, Daisy!
He's
all
so happy. I could just cry.
Now, now. Everything's gonna be just fine.
How can it be? Now that my man's gone, I just never get married.
Well, what you say that for?
Who'd want me now? I've waited around so long, I've plumb wasted away.
Well, that may be, honey, but what you got left over is more than what most folks starts out with.
No, Sam. I looked in the smear this morning, and there's no doubt about it. My good years is gone.
I guess you're right. After all, you is pushing 18.
Thank you. In the rock.
do anything for you.
How are we ever going to defeat a strong force like General Blue Moose?
Just name someone you don't like.
We don't have any power.
And I'll bust in his skull.
No one's strong enough to.
Lil Abner's in terrible trouble. Maybe get killed if we don't help him out.
That's a crying shame. But if you marry me, I'd be willing to.
All right, of course.
I'd be willing
to. I will.
You will?
Easy.
What are you saying, gal?
On one condition.
What's that?
That you come back to Washington and use your brute strength to help save Lil Abner's life.
If an eye does, you solemn promise to give yourself to me?
I solemn promises to give myself to you.
Body and soul?
Body and soul.
Is that one at a time or both together?
You take your pick.
Lady, you just got yourself one passport to ecstasy.
No, we ain't got time.
We gonna need help. You go get those ornery scrags and anybody else that can scrap. And tell them to bring their socializing clothes.
Fry soup and fish?
That's right. We's heading for high society, and when we get there, there ain't gonna be anyone soupier or fishier than we is.
Are you absolutely sure the government won't delay those tests?
I've tried for a day and a half, but it's no use. Yoakum gives them the rights at midnight tonight.
Midnight, is it? If I can't get possession of that Yoakum Berry Tannic, at least I can get Yoakum to give me the secret formula. And there's only one man for the job. Press my evil eye Flegel button.
You sent for me, boss?
Flegel, I only have till midnight to get that secret formula from Abner Yoakum. You have a whammy that'll make a man tell the truth?
Certainly. It's known as Flegel's famous nod for barricading veracitizing truth whammy. Now, what don't you want on this whammy? The truth? The whole truth? The half truth? Or a little of each?
You mean you got a half truth talent whammy?
In Washington, it's one of my biggest items.
But who is he? What happens to Yoakum after you get the formula?
Then we proceed with Flegel's original plan.
Right. I give him my suicidal sports car whammy. He jumps in some handy Jaguar and drives himself off the nearest cliff.
Capital. Veracitize him at once.
Okay. Who gets him loaded?
Loaded?
My truth whammy only works when the victim's gassed, pickled, under the influence of alcohol.
But, Boosie, you know Abner doesn't drink.
Why not?
He says he's 100% red-blooded American. And no 100% red-blooded American drinks, smokes, tells naughty jokes, necks, pets, or smooches.
Then who gave this country a population of 160 million?
Some oversexed subversives.
There must be some way to get that boy to take a drink.
What about the society party you're giving us tonight?
Aha! We've got him. No 100% American would dare refuse to toast his prospective bride. Champagne, all right?
Champagne's perfect.
Good, then proceed as planned. Now remember, we all have a job to do. You too, appassionata.
But Rosie's sweet. What happens if I make a mistake and louse everything up? What then?
You'll be back at Howard Johnson's before noon.
Three rosy rods, a few muzzles, and a hip hip hip.
We got to work fast. Earthquake, Sam, you head on back to the gate. Tell the others to wait in case we need things.
Right.
Now, you two scoot.
What you mean, gal?
Abner will never go on his own free will. He lives by the coat of the hills, and he's promised to get married. You know, he'd die first before he'd break a promise. There's only one way to convince him. I'll just have to use my feminine wiles.
Feminine wiles.
Daisy, what are you doing here?
I just had to come, Abner.
Well, how'd you get in?
I sneaked in. Oh, Abner, I just had to see you once more.
Gosh, Daisy, you sure is a sight for sore eyes.
Am I, Abner?
You sure is.
I come up here, Abner, because since I knows you so well, I thought maybe I could give your intended some advice.
Advice?
About some of the things that makes you happy.
Sure is sweet of you, Daisy.
Like your breakfast. How much cream and sugar you like on your cold pork chops.
Miss Appassionata ain't the cold pork chop type.
How to dig your special worms and bait your hook. But most of all, how to fix up your home. So it'd be a nice loving home. Like the one you and I might have had.
Would have been a right nice one, too.
Remember that piece of land Joan's liked?
Smack between Poison Oak Gulch and Contagious Lane?
Right behind the school.
Nice view of the skunk works.
Oh, we'd have had a sweet little place, Abner. Not some big old cold house like this one. Just close your eyes. Picture it.
I can see a rocking chair. A lamp, a couch, and...
love, Abner. Don't forget love.
You can tell when you open the door. You can tell when there's love in a home. Every picture you see seems to say, you
Mr. Passionatus pining to marry me, and I ain't aimed to break no more hearts than I already has.
Then what will now, Abner Yoakum? That's right, they's aiming to kill you. That General Bullies and your precious intended.
How can you say such a terrible thing?
But it's true. I just heard it in this very room.
Daisy, I'm starting to get angry. You're making this up on account of your poor gal who's still miserably in love with me.
No, Abner.
For which I don't blame you, because I can understand how it could happen.
Abner Yoakum, run for your life.
Daisy, I want you to go back home and forget all about me.
No, Abner.
You heard me. I have spoken.
Gonna save that boy's life whether he wants it or not, even if we all got busted into that ballroom tonight.
About a disturbance at the gate.
It's true, sir. There's a mob of horrible-looking hillbillies at the gate as they've arrived at a party, sir.
What's that?
There's a little old lady with a pipe. Says she's Yoakum's mother. Said if you don't let him in, it looks suspicious. Are you trying to hide something, sir?
Okay. What is it?
Said something like going straight to Mike Wallace, sir.
Mike Wallace! I can't afford an incident when I only have till midnight to get the secret formula. All right, let them in.
Let them in?
Yes, sir.
Go keep an eye on Yoakum. Make sure he doesn't know they're here.
Yes, sir. General, you're not really going to let those miserable hillbillies into your home.
My dear, you've got the... put up with these kind of things these days. There's no telling what you have to do to get your hands on a measly couple of $1 billion.
But what if they should be seen? Think about your dignity.
Dignity? Dignity is a thing of the past. Vanderbilt, Astor, Rockefeller, they could afford dignity. They didn't have to put up with all this modern day nonsense. Social Security, old age pensions, filtered cigarettes. I warned them, but they wouldn't listen. I said, you put a radical like Jimmy Carter in the White House, and they call it progress. Progress is the root of all evil. Progress is the cause of it all. I had to change my neighborhood. Say, where is Levittown? Millionaires are getting old-fashioned. Labor is the new thing, craze. These crazy basic minimums are getting so high. The workers at the plant are living better than I. My lawyers all tell me that it's cheaper to die. Bring back the good old. Progress is the root of all evil. Wall Street is the worst of the lot. How can you break the market? How? The SEC will not allow one little panic. Money nowadays is no problem. Not with all these new giveaways. I went to see a television quiz show today. I thought at least I'd wind up with a caddy coupe. But damn it if they didn't try to give me away. Bring back the good old days. Progress is the root of all evil. Progress is the cause of them all. The world has now progressed so far. We don't know where the hell we are. Ask Harry G. Truman.
That you aim to hurt our good friend Abner, whom we loves and adores.
Preposterous.
Well, we was wrong, and so we'll go, and quietly.
Double-crossing! Snake in the grass!
Earthquake, you's a gentleman.
Why, thank you, Abner. But I sure like us all apart friends, so I'm asking you, Brother Bull Moose, to let us join you in a toast to Abner and the future Mrs. Yoakum.
Why, you no good possible!
Well, I'm not one to harbor a grudge. Ladies, champagne!
I told you he was real friendly-like.
To the bride-to-be, may the flower of her innocence burst into blossom and bring joy to this fine young man.
Truth-wamified Mr. Bull Moose.
Bruce.
Yeah! Look like you lovable brat. We got him.
Now you gotta tell the truth.
Mr. Colonel, just you listen. General Bulmos, is you or is you not a no-good double-crossing finagling crook?
Would you repeat the question?
Is you or is you not a no-good double-crossing thieving crook?
Yes, madam, I am.
And just what did you intend doing with Abner Yoakum?
Subject him to evil eye Flegel's truth whammy.
So he tell you?
The secret of Yoakumberry tonic.
Whereupon you intended to?
Further use the nefarious E.E. Flegel.
The purpose being?
To put a suicidal whammy on the gullible Yoakum.
Whereupon the poor fool would?
Jump into my fastest sports car.
And subsequently?
Drive himself over the nearest cliff.
Making it appear like?
Accidental death.
When for real and true it was?
Cold-blooded premeditated murder.
There you have it, a confessed murderer. Take him away.
Hereby ordered to return to their homes immediately and resume their orderly evacuation.
Evacuation?
You crazy man? The bomb has been called off.
There are buses waiting down the road to transport you back to Dogpatch.
But Mr. Scientist, ma'am, what about our Yoakumberry tonic?
The tests have been declared a failure.
A failure?
Now attention, all you women whose husbands have been used as guinea pigs. There is a special bus waiting to take you back to the laboratory. Mr. Yoakum, I'm afraid you'll have to come along with them.
What for?
You'll find out at the laboratory. Step lively, everyone. Come along, Mr. Yoakum. This way, ladies.
Wait a minute! I earned you fair and square. You's coming with me now.
Please, not after I find out what's gonna happen to Abner, please.
All right, but remember, yours mine now forever and forever.
Yes, Earthquake. I'm yours now.
Demonstrated that while Yoakumberry tonic will make men physically perfect, eternally youthful, and incredibly attractive. They unfortunately lose all romantic interest whatsoever.
My God, they've all become Lil Abners!
Precisely!
You can't do that to us!
What are we gonna do now?
It's inhuman!
Why'd we ever let them come?
No!
I'm sorry, lady.
But you can't leave them like this!
You just can't!
Put them back! To hold you, make me mine.
I got something to say.
Hesha, I never should have given that tonic. I should have known.
Mammy, I could be hers.
I said, Hesh, why didn't I know better? Why didn't I realize?
Now, Mammy, you gonna listen to me.
Will you, Hesh, up your little pipsqueak?
No, you, Hesha.
What?
For once, you gonna hash and you gonna stay hash. I got some private talk to do with my boy, and by gum, I'm gonna do it.
But heck?
Now you get, I sees you when I gets back to dog patch, if and I takes a notion to.
But heck?
Get! I have spoken!
Son, I want you to hear this. Son, supposing I was to tell you that there may be a way out of your miserable condition.
Oh, Pappy, don't make light out of something so serious.
Oh, but there is, son. There's a sure way.
What is it?
It's a special potion developed by our beloved founder, Jubilation T. Corn.
But, Pappy, I've taken enough potions and tonics already.
Oh, but you ain't never taken Corn Bones. Powerfully potent, perpetually passionizing and romanticizing potion.
Will that potion romanticize me and put those boys back the way they was?
All I can tell you is when I was your age, I had a mighty you trouble myself. And so I took me a swing of that there potion.
What happened?
Well, as I wiped my lips, your sweet, ugly little old man, he came walking by. And all I can tell you is that that sawed-off, shriveled-up, miserable little creature looked to me like Lillian Russell and Marilyn Monroe and Kim Novak all rolled up into one.
Well, what is we waiting for?
Now, there's one special condition that goes with this potion. It only works if you really and truly want it to work.
Oh, I does, Pappy, more than anything in the whole world.
Well, then, let's get going. That wedding ain't gonna wait for man or beast. And with earthquake, that covers both ends. Hello, Western Union. I wants to place a call to Mammy Oakham and Daisy May Scragg and Mary and Sam, Dog Patch USA. The message, just three words. Stop! Stop! Stop!
Only, I do wish you'd wait, Earthquake, dear. Time our kinfolk get here.
such a nice new home?
Of course, my dear.
With their new rich relative?
Most assuredly, my pet. Rich relative? Who?
Why, you, of course.
Me?
You don't think a scraggy little another scraggy are homeless, long as they was related to anyone as well-heeled as the world's dirtiest wrestler.
You mean you want them three miserable scrags come live with us?
Naturally. The others will be along directly. I sent Speedy McGrabbit out to tell them all the good news. I knew you'd want it that way, ugly dear. Well, upon my soul's Uncle Unsociable Scrag and his three fine children. Unthinkable, unbearable, and unwashable. Say hello to your new rich relative.
And look who come out of the swamp, unappetizing Scrag.
Howdy, baby! Well, upon my soul, if it isn't the Scarsdale Scrags.
Howdy, Daisy.
Well, Sam, ain't you got some marrying to do?
I sure has. Well, batten down your hatches and grab hold of each other while I let's fly with my $8 wedding.
Who got married and so began that visible race of creatures known as the married man. And think about Samson, who was Israel's strongest male.
The strongest.
Till little Delilah went and gave him a ponytail. Those fatal words.
Fatal words.
Just let me remind you, getting married is for the birds.
For the birds.
Stop the crack of dawn.
That's right.
Stop the hunt and the bones of law.
Oh, so.
Stop the wood for the bones of joy.
Uh-huh.
The rainy as well out those.
That's right.
You come home to familiar scenes.
Ah, yes.
The way to familiar beats.
Oh, no.
The way to one of you scream and kiss.
All mine.
The way to both of you flip your lips.
What else?
You is your black of your skin.
Your nose.
Say stop this wedding?
That's right. I might claim Daisy Man for myself when Pappy gets here with Cornpone's passionizing and romanticizing potion.
But there ain't no such potion.
Oh, yes, there is.
Wait a minute. Maybe there is and maybe there isn't. But I want to say something. This here little gal has loved this fine boy all of her life. And even if it means giving up my passport to ecstasy and all these fine family ties, I'm willing to make a sacrifice.
Hey, what about our passport?
You can't do that.
Besides, there ain't no such potion.
I say it. I got it. Here it is, son. Now remember, it only works if you really and truly wants it to work.
Oh, I does, Pappy. I sure does.
What is it, Chuck Pappy?
Oh, just a little old creek water, Mammy. Some plain old creek water.
Daisy!
I pronounce this you,
Melon! Wait, Pappy,
Lincoln?
Just listen here. Because of his lack of strategy, his military blunders, and his general ineptness, which almost single-handedly encouraged the North to win this Civil War, a grateful government dedicates this statue of General Jubilation T. Cornbone, proclaiming it a national shrine.
Good God, it's a national shrine.
You can't deface it, you can't move it, and you can't bomb it.
You're absolutely right. Notify Washington to stop that plane. Citizens of Dogpatch, the evacuation is ended.
Until we pay homage to the one man who made all this possible. Who romanticized this boy? Who put him back the way they was? Who saved our town from being bombed? None other than that beloved man, a sitting up there on that beloved horse, Jubilation T. Cornpone.